Hi guys, it's Michael, G0POT here. I've got quite a few small QRP CW trail friendly radios, and every time I take one out I have to remember to pack one of the external keys. So I thought it'd be quite nice to build a key into one of the radios, and I decided to build a touch keyer with a couple of external contacts to touch. I've gone for a kit from Javier, Echo Alpha 3 Golf Charlie Yankee, and I'm going to build his TKEY-1 touch keyer kit and try and fit it inside one of my little QRP radios. Now this is a fairly simple kit, there's not a lot to it, so it should be a fairly straightforward build. It's all through hole components, so let's get this built and try it out and see if we can get it fitted in a radio and on the air. If you're not sure what a CW touch keyer is, it's a pair of solid state switches that use a capacitive touch to activate. It doesn't create dits and dahs like a CW keyer, it simply replicates the mechanical switches that you normally use in the form of a single or double paddle. There are no moving parts. By touching one of the two capacitive contacts, the keyer switches one of the outputs to ground, effectively creating a short circuit as if you'd closed a switch, and this can drive the CW keyer built into your own radio. Touch keys can give you a silent operation that might be desirable if you're in a room with others and removes the issues of dirt, temperature or transportation affecting the normal mechanical paddle when operating portable. The kit can be ordered and the manual downloaded from Echo Alpha 3 Golf Charlie Yankee's website. The 12-page manual is available in English and Spanish and covers both the basic kit and a version that comes with a case. The kit ships with the main PCB and 18 through-hole components, plus two surface mount capacitive touch sensors which come pre-installed on the PCB. The manual has a parts list to check off the components and very kindly includes guides to identifying the components to make this reasonably foolproof. The PCB has a clear component overlay and the diagram in the manual explicitly shows the orientation of the diodes. Let's start building. We start by installing the two 22K and two 10K resistors that lay flat on the PCB. The hole spacing on the PCB for the resistors is a little tight. Bend the legs at right angles flush to the body of the resistors, otherwise you'll struggle to get them to fit. Next, I'm installing the seven small capacitors in the same way as I did the resistors. Once those are in place, I can add the electrolytic. The holes for the three diodes have been made a little close together, which means we can't install them laying flat. I'm guessing this was a mistake with the PCB design or that the original components are no longer available. As it is, we simply have to install the diodes upright, paying close attention to their orientation and ensuring we don't apply heat for too long, which could damage the diode. There are two transistors that act as our solid state switches. Be gentle bending their legs to fit the holes on the circuit board and note the component screen printed on the PCB shows the orientation of the transistors. The third component that looks like a transistor is actually the 5-volt regulator. The circuit can be powered from a 7 to 15 volt DC supply, and this regulates the power to the sensors and transistors to 5 volts. The final thing to add are the header pins. I typically solder a single pin and then check that the header pin unit is sat flat and perpendicular to the board before soldering the remainder of the pins. Be warned, don't hold the pins in place with a finger while applying heat to the solder the other end. They conduct heat very effectively. And that's it. We're now ready to test. After testing, we could add the touch panels that the kit comes with, but I intend to install this in a radio and add stainless steel acorn dome nuts as the paddles. Connecting a 12 volt DC supply to the power input and a multimeter to the output pins, I can check that the output is shorted when I touch the left and right pads. Here, I've temporarily installed the keyer into my QRP Labs QCX transceiver and mocked up the case to enable the paddles to be mounted. So, what's my final verdict? The TKEY-1 touch keyer kit is quick and simple to build, and from my limited experience seems to work really well. The kit itself is well priced at €18, but note that shipping adds another €12, which brings the total cost up to €30. The final build PCB is 40 by 40mm square and needs a height clearance of about 13mm, although you could probably half that with some basic modifications. The kit does come with paddle pieces, and there is a custom metal case available from Javier if you want to make a standalone touch keyer. I'm pleased with the quality of the kit, and it's now an integral part of my QRP Labs QCX transceiver. I hope you find that useful if you're looking for a touch keyer. Whatever you're up to, make sure you get out there and enjoy your radio.